by the way.
Oh, well, yeah.
I'm very conservative, yeah.
Oh, that's good.
I've been here, even though I'm from Mexico, I'm an American citizen, but, you know, I'm supporting law, I support President Trump, yeah. You know, for him, I'm supporting. Yeah. But you know what happened? The media.
Oh, sure, of course.
The media, because most of the people I know, people come from Mexico, they hardworking people.
Yes.
They don't live off the government. They work, they pay taxes. They do not agree with all these people to abusing the system. Yeah. But see, what happened, you know, the media, especially the Spanish media here in the USA,
really?
The Spanish channel, Univision, Telemundo, you know, they keep talking trash every day in the news about the president. Always keep talking trash about him. But they never, ever asked where that man in the last, 15, 16 months being the president, I mean, Dow Jones went up, sorry. Unemployment went down, you know, and all the tax cut he did, yeah. ISIS pretty much is almost gone.
Yes,
you know,
exactly.
they never ever mentioned all the good things he been done.
Yeah.
He always mentioned all the bad things, and one of the mistakes of my people, over Mexican people, they only see news in Spanish or they see CNN. Fuck CNN!
Right.
I told them, you get your own read, I study, and make your own mind. Don't let the news tell you what's going on. They tell you what you want to believe.
Exactly.
Yeah. But I'm agreeing.
Well, you're right on. These guys try to control the message. You're right on with
that. Yeah, they try to control the message.
You're right on.
All the Spanish or immigrants in the United States, they hate President Trump because the media, every day put in their mind. And you know, everything he does, they exaggerate. Like, for example, a week ago when we bombed Syria, you know, they say, the crazy President Trump, he has started the war. We have a war. He's a crazy. He could not control. He went to attack the poor Syrian country. I said, come on. I mean, there's no. I said, you know what? Assad did. He used a chemical weapon against
well, I have some contained some pushback on that. I like a lot of what Trump does. But one of the things that our founding fathers warned us against was foreign intervention, getting involved in foreign wars.
Mm-hmm.
I'm pretty strong in that too. I don't like us. And there's some question because of whom exactly did that attack, or even if there was an attack.
Mm-hmm.
We attacked that country with no investigation.
You're right, not no investigation.
So, you know, I'm a little bit, let's hold off a little on that.
Well, you're right,
but everything else.
You have a point, yeah.
Yeah, everything else you brought up is right on target. He's pushing things forward. But I think overall, considering, because we're in a pretty corrupt place. I mean, you know, Mexico is very corrupt. Mexico's got more resources than the United States get. Mexico should be one of the strongest countries in the world with the resources.
I'm agreeing with that.
Yeah.
But
because of the corruption, it's being held back. And it's the same thing here. We just hide it a little bit better.
Exactly. Hide it a little bit better. You're right in that.
But it's a struggle, and you're going to struggle even worse because you're probably right. Is there any right-leaning Spanish programs at all? I mean, or there's anybody speaking like you would if you had your...
yeah. You know, like...
Maybe on the internet, is there anybody on the internet that speaks truth rather than propaganda?
There is some. Well, I'll find some in Facebook. So someone to
us social
website. And they talk about the more real thing. He don't talk about the. He don't go by what the news say.
Right.
No.
Yeah.
I mean.
Well, that's
like, for example, you know, right now, what the news all this week? They've been talking about. About the you know, 2 weeks ago, the president, about the girls, this is prostitutes, Stormy Daniels.
Yeah.
I mean, why do you care? That happened 10 years, 11 years ago. Who cares? Doesn't have nothing to do with the way how he's working, how he's running the country. He had nothing to do with that.
Well, you've already brought up the important issues. My taxes.
Exactly, wouldn't
I? Right, you know?
Uh-huh.
Am I going to be employed?
Right now we got
right.
Boom.
Right. You know, jobs. Can I put food on the table? Are my bills going to be paid?
Exactly.
Is the country going to be secure?
Uh-huh.
Talk to me about that.
Yeah.
Why don't you get those things squared away, we can watch.
And, you know, I talk with a lot of people, Mexicans, who really don't speak English, and I say, well, he don't do nothing. I say, yeah, I do nothing, because see, right now, see, I know people like 5 years ago, 10 years ago, working in construction, people, and they say, well, there's not too many jobs, we only work 3 days, I mean, too much work is working only 3 days a week, 4 days a week. Now the construction, you know, they used to start paying to the laborers like $10, $10. Now laborers, they started paying $15, and they need people, they need labor for construction. I say, look, you got a lot of jobs, you work in Saturdays, you work in 60 hours a week. You know what? Thanks to him. Maybe you don't see that, right? Really say, yeah. You see, Dow Jones went up. That means the investor put more money to build buildings, to build that, so they kept the economy going faster. That was used to be with Obama. I mean, all things I hear about the news, they never say Obama, the debt went to 19 trillion. He took it when it was like 10 trillion of nine.
Yeah.
He went out, the national debt at 19 trillion, the deficit. I mean, but the media don't talk about that. They don't talk about, they're talking about Stormy Daniels.
Yeah. But the good news, I think, is more and more people are stopping to listen. They're not listening to that stuff.
No.
Unfortunately, they don't have any alternative. That's why I said the internet. Going to places like, you know, InfoWars or Drudge, you can get some real news. But they don't have Spanish editions of those, which they should have.
Yeah, they should have.
I mean, that's... Because, I mean, how many...
Because the main trio, the main two networks, TV networks, national networks, the latest Univision and Telemundo, they against President Trump. I mean, any bad thing he said, they accelerate. Make him
propaganda. Big.
And
talk, it's not news,
yeah, propaganda.
It's propaganda.
It's propaganda. Right. Do it. And what they do, and you know, unfortunately, a lot of Mexican people don't speak too much English. They always watch Spanish news.
Sure.
So it's the only thing they know. They know how to hate President Trump.
Yeah, that's why we need a right wing Spanish.
We need that.
You ought to get one. You ought to go start your own blog and get on the YouTube and, you know, and be a spokesman for the Spanish.
This is a good idea.
Yes.
A good idea.
You know what you're talking about?
Oh, yeah. I mean, that's it. You know, always analyze and see the situation. I mean, the media can tell you, oh, the economy or something talking bad, but I see the economy. I see a lot of people spending money.
You'd get a good following real quick because people know the truth when they hear it.
Yeah.
They know the truth when they hear it.
Exactly.
And if you just started out small, I guarantee you, you'd start, you know, maybe throw a little money in the advertising or something, you know, market. You probably get a lot of followers in a short period of time.
Yeah, that's
true. Then you'd have to quit your job, you know, you'd have to.
Oh, yes, and that was nice to you.
Oh, it's a pleasure indeed. It was a pleasure meeting you.
All right. I'll let you.
Thank you. Here, let me give you a get out of jail free card from Hillary Clinton.
Yeah, this should be in the jail a long time ago.
Amen.
Yeah.
Amen.
It's a long time ago, you know. But, I mean, you know, FBI, protect him, everybody protect him.
It's a pleasure talking to you.
All right, nice to meet you.